Well, everybody, I think we are blessed to have the Walt Disney Family Museum right here in San Francisco in the Presidio. It's good for kids, sure, but it's really for adults, too. It's got everything from Fantasia to the days on television of the Disney TV shows and all he did that was so unusual. Also, a miniaturization of what he wanted Disneyland to look like. There's so much going on there. It's so much fun. The original paints from Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. It's just crazy. All his Oscars are there. It's at the Walt Disney Family Museum. The man who has the job of all jobs is Michael LaBrie. Tell us what you do, Michael.
I am the director of collections and exhibitions, so I get to work with preservation and presentation of all the art in the museum.
It's incredible. And that includes the multi-plane camera.
Yes, there's all sorts of camera equipment that no one would see.
Right.
It's pretty impressive. And you being our biggest fan
is just such a joy. The multi-plane camera is better than the 3D that I sit through now.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yes, the multi-plane camera, the artists were able to bring depth into the animation. It was revolutionary.
And you also have a small version of Dick Van Dyke showing you through different equipment how Mary Poppins was made with animation and live action.
Yes, using the matte backgrounds, and they could combine footage to create animation with live action.
And how many Oscars are there?
26.
26 Oscars, okay.
Including the Thalberg Award and a special exhibition. I mean, excuse me, a special award for Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs.
Yeah, and there's some beautiful international trophies. Crazy.
Over 248 awards and honors that he received.
Yeah. Now, what's so amazing? Everybody says, well, Walt Disney, wait, I heard some bad things. Well, you know what? You guys deal with that. You deal with what he did during the McCarthy era, some of the problems he had with the strikes of the studio employees.
Well,
but you also show all the amazing things he did.
Yes, his daughter, Diane Disney Miller, she started this museum as a way to, you know, debunk all the myths that have been told about her dad.
Mm-hmm.
She wanted people to meet the man and form your own decision about him.
And you really get to. It's such an honest, wonderful, colorful. I mean, we're showing some of them. Oh, this is the other side of that. It's the Golden Gate Bridge. This is this beautiful glass part where you get to see the naturalist
TV
shows.
Yeah, the True Life Adventures. And then probably one of the best views of the Golden Gate Bridge from our gallery.
That's right. It's really beautiful. But there's so many videos. You know, I took some people recently, and they couldn't believe how much video there was and how many telephones there were to pick up and listen to the animated themselves.
Yes.
And now you always have a special exhibit. Right now you have the trains.
Yes, it's all aboard Celebration of Walt's Trains. So Walt was introduced to trains early on in life, and it was an inspiration to him both in work and life. And he had his own miniature train surrounding his house in Holmby Hills.
Yeah.
And his inspiration for trains showed up in films and all of the theme parks.
And you have a special exhibit of that.
We do.
And then you have another special exhibit of some of the newly found.
Well, Schulteis' notebook, it's the lost notebook, and it talks about the magic of Disney's films. It's behind the scenes, and it was created by this man who was a cameraman in special effects. He documented it.
And it's right there. It's so interesting, and he works so hard to get unusual movies made, to get animals to talk and to be real human, you know, to have so much humanity.
Yes,
it's
absolutely.
Just, I mean, he was more like Edison than he was Louis B. Mera. I mean, this was Disney was a genius, a true genius.
Well, there's over 200 monitors throughout the Walt Disney Family Museum, and it's just inspirational to everyone that comes.
People have got to get there. It's at the Presidio, the Walt Disney Family Museum. That, what you just saw, was a truck that he drove during World War I. I mean, there's everything about his life, but also about his art and his courage to do it his way, and lots about the TV shows. Oh, it's just a blast. So that's it at the Montgomery Street Presidio in San Francisco. Just go onto their website, waltdisney.org, and it is just so wonderful, like Michael LaBrie. And here's a few movies that I love that are about, this tells you how much it is to get into it, and it is so worth it. And they have a place you can eat there and all kinds of things in a beautiful gift shop. These are some movies I really recommend on DVD. El Grupo, when Disney went during
Goodwill Tour
of South America.
South America, yes.
Oh, it's fantastic. It's where he got the idea for some of of those great South American music cartoons. Frank and Ollie are about two of the old men who were part of the animation team. Ub Iwerks, his granddaughter, did a wonderful documentary, Leslie, about Ub Iwerks. Look him up. Fascinating. Walt Disney, the man behind the magic and the triumph of the American imagination, Walt Disney. All of those worth seeing. You know, I know you want to know my top 10 movies, right? Okay, I know you want to know that. And here they are real quick. I did it a couple weeks ago, but people have been really bothering me to do it again. Number 10 is The Galapagos Affair, When Satan Came to Eden. It's a documentary. Still Alice, number 9. Ida, a Polish film, number 8. 7 is Men, Women, and Children, about how technology, we have to remember that humanity comes first. St. Vincent, number 6, really worth seeing. Wonderful Bill Murray performance. 5 is Birdman. 4 is Selma. Do not miss Selma. Comes out in 2 weeks. Theory of Everything, number 3. Number 2, a fabulous film now available on DVD called Pride, that is just... it just will make you feel good at the end, and that's rare these days. And finally, number 1 is The Imitation Game. And what is that?
Okay, this is, we're giving you the sneak preview of our next exhibition,
yes.
George Harrell. And you live in the golden age of Hollywood.
I do.
So you're the one that we need to tell about.
All right, this is George Harrell's Hollywood. It's coming to the Walt Disney Family Museum in February?
It opens in February.
I'll be there, and so will you. We're talking about the great days of Hollywood. How much better can it get than that? And those movies only get better as time goes by. We'll be back after this.